Hey people, Infantry 53, Hades Wastes Blue Team. Joe Kuda is a Force Commander of Regular Offense, fights in melee combat, can also tank, disrupt, and support with buffs. Looks like we've got some orange Imperial Fists here, maybe some successor chapter or something, alongside. This is the fellow, the pacifist, I think, with a Warlock, a melee spellcaster that can leap into combat, some powerful disruption and support. And rounding off the blue team, Corrupted Jesus is a Plague Champion. Starts off in ranged combat with a damage of a time bolt gun, can get melee weapons, some decent utility and support, can build turrets and repair, but it's pretty slow. Red team, we have two Tech Marines first up, Gotez, Always Relaxed, and Lauer. These guys start off in ranged combat with a bolt gun, can get a melee weapon, and can also support the structures and repair. We got some Imperial Fists, and these fellas. Alongside, rounding off the team's ever faithful Leo built, with a Commander Knob, infiltrating hero that shoots you, stabs you, and blows you up. Orky Style begins in ranged combat with a Twin Link Shooter. Gets rid of the Banshees, has double Sluggers, one of them runs away though. And they should be able to push through the mid onto the power maybe. Got some support from the Tech Marine too. Where's the Force Commander? Okay, they grabbed that and noded it. Force Commander should be able to make a big difference here. Where are his scouts? They be back capping. Kraken Bolts. They're using Kraken Bolts on the Force Commander, which is a mistake. Should be using it on the enemy tacks. Got a special attack on the Tech Marine, and the Tech Marine knocked over two of the Tactical Marines. That was pretty good. Commando's being all sneaky-like, getting away from the scary chaos stuff. Those two heretics. Big threat to the Sluggers. What are these fellas trying to do? Force Commander backed off, which draws these guys in. They're trying to get close for a shotgun blast. There it is. But now the Force Commander gets stuck in. Oh, needs to be careful. Runs away. Surely they can get a model off these tacks here. Did these guys, these orange guys, use their Kraken Bolts already? Wow, how did you survive with three models on 205 hit points? Destructor coming in out of nowhere. Almost finished off those scouts. These guys get away without a model loss. Commando chucks out the stun bomb. I don't think it's going to hit anything though. And Banshee's on the prowl. Looks like blue team will take the Western VP then. East side, meanwhile, got some Nurgle worship. We got heretics getting close to stuff, doom blasting, suppressing two squads. They're gonna need to retreat. Yet more heretics coming in. Where's the plague champion? He's on his way. They noted this. Did Lauer? Well, it's gonna be bashed, and it might be a triple cap actually for blue team early on. Typically, wouldn't see a triple this early in the game. These tactical marines are trying to get a flamer going. But they're just standing out of cover here. They'll take a lot of damage from a commando. His Twin Link Shooter is pretty good at the shooting. Are they going to drop a model here? Oh, they're going to get close. All those bursts are going on one model. There's the flamer, but they can't use it for bashing right now. Sluggers are going to catch them. There's the melee charge. They might get a special too because these guys are moving. There it is. They're in big trouble now. Going to drop at least one model. Two models down. Looks like the Devastator's coming in to help them out with some suppression. And a big retreat there. That was a good destructor. Scouts moving up for some reason. What are they up to? The Sluggers are gone, guys. They're gone. Are they trying to finish off the commando, maybe? What's the Force Commander doing now? Eats a shotgun blast. Gonna need to retreat. Really didn't need to do that. Had a Shuriken back here. Had Devastators back here. It was up to the red team to push. Misplay from Joe Kuda. Still a bunch of Eldar stuff here, though, with grenade and banshees and a Warlock, of course. We have a Mastercrafted Bolter here for Lauer. Has to run away though. CSM getting stuck into melee, as are Heretics. And they've managed these engagements quite well so far, has Corrupted Jesus. West side, is it kicking off? I think it is. Devastators, I think, got stun bombed there. That's why they're backing off now. Immolator goes in. Immolator now does damage over time on its ranged attacks. Yes, it does. I believe that's set to be toned down in 293. Steal the triple cap. Oh, down goes the Warlock. Can red team get through the Shuriken? Surely they can. Yeah, here comes Sluggers. Red team are going to take the western side. But the Force Commander, wow, the Force Commander really couldn't get back in time, eh? Took him a while to heal up there. Got these flame attacks. We have a single Devastator. Knows how to use the Heavy Bolter. What are these fellas doing? Oh, they were capping in a strange configuration there. The scouts have their sergeant. These guys, again, just venturing out of cover. trying to flame stuff. Yeah, it's not going to work out for you guys. Double cap now for the blue team. Some Nurgle worship in the mid. Havoc's getting jumped by the Assault Marines of Laur. And weighing in with some Bolts of Fire too. Mastercrafted Bolter will tear through Default Heretics pretty quickly. Can they get the Havocs? They can get the Havocs. Bit of a wayward jump if these guys are going for the Havocs there, but the Sluggers finish it off. They don't have Burners yet, but they're doing pretty well. Ever Faithful Leo Built goes tier 2, as does Corrupted Jesus and Gotez. We've got Slugger Knobs queued up for tier 2. Those guys have power melee weapons and they will tear up Marines all day long. Devastators now for Laur, tier 2 for the Pacifist. Red team been a little bit static on the west side, not wanting to overextend for a power bash. Understandable, but I always think you should try. 500 to 273, blue team haven't lost a VP yet. They're about to though, red team are getting a natural back. Here we see fully upgraded Sluggers all of a sudden. Slugger Knob and Burners makes them exponentially more dangerous in tier 2. And a War Truck, surely? Yes, so a War Truck is already up, in fact, by Leo Built. Good grenade goes in. It's well dodged, though, by Gotez. Sluggers are waiting. Not getting involved yet. They want to War Truck around, I think. Banshee War Shout. What aspect do you have, ladies? Aspect of Strength. Here's the War Truck. Banshees don't have their Exarch yet, so they won't have their fancy spear. This Shuriken Cannon is in big trouble now. Big trouble. Should have retreated as soon as they saw the War Truck. Looks like they are down. Yep, they are done for. Devastators will now need to be careful. Force Commanders here. How about a Thunderhammer, buddy? You've got two angry Slugger squads to deal with. Are these guys going to get away? So much damage so quickly. Looks like they're alright. I think the way they parked so close to them messed up the pathing of the Sluggers a little bit. Might have made the difference. Now they can burn down the generators. Meanwhile, towards the east, red team putting pressure on blue team's natural VP now. These heretics do have an aspiring champion. Not sure what they're going for. Mark of Khorne. Chaos Space Marines with chain axes, which are power melee weapons. More than a match to those Assault Marines there. Yeah, those guys are in trouble. Can they jump away? They can jump away. Dropped a model in midair somehow, but they're alright. And defended the VP, well done. Can even maybe get onto it with the Plague Champion. I just heard the Banshees yell, and they're in trouble. Big trouble, they're going down. Just got their Exarch, I think. But that's what double Sluggers can do for you. I think they were trying to chase the War Truck, yeah. Look how much damage the War Truck took. Dreadnought for Gotez. The Pacifist has some Wraith Guard. Needs to protect them from the Sluggers though, eh? Maybe... Nope, we still have Immolator. No sign of Witchblade of Conus. Ethereal Slash Shenanigans. Champion's Robe also up. A little bit depleted here, Pacifist. Jokuda goes tier 3. No Thunderhammer. The Sluggers are running riot right now. Gotez is the player on the west here, so there's going to be a Dreadnought now to deal with. And some repairs for the War Truck. I'm pretty sure that's heresy, fellas. A Tarantula Turret from Laur over here, defending the power, the contested power. Easy to flank, but a little wild to get around there. Doomblast and... not quite a flea. Doomblast and a measured back away. Noise Marines with their Blastmaster. Might get a big shot on his Tactical Marines here. If they didn't retreat, that might have whacked them out. Assault Marines are going to jump him, I guess, but there's loads here to counter-initiate. No, quite wisely backing away. Blade Champion's now got his Plague Fist. Meanwhile, west side, there's your Dreadnought. Starts off as a melee walker. And Wraith Guard don't like melee very much, especially from things like this. Gonna get torn up. Yeah, need to retreat. Got double Tactical Marines, of course, still as well. What are these guys doing? Lucky that special attack didn't just wipe them out. Somehow they got away with four models. We now have a Wraith Lord from the Pacifist. West side. Oh, they got this fully built up, have they? Commando's trying to bash it. Now has some help. From sluggers, this guy needs repairs on his war truck. It's done well so far already. They really haven't dealt with those sluggers very well, have they? Jokuda, force commander's down. Now getting a predator tank. East side, touch of Nurgle heretics. Looks like there's nothing to... Oh, tech marines here. Can spread your disgusting crap to him. He's running away. Prince of the turret suppresses all the things. They're trying to get around it. There's some Nurgle worship. Oh, those guys exploded. Those guys be dead. Lost some upgraded heretics. They were probably leveled up as well. And now being flanked by some more suppression in the form of Devastators. Plaguefish should be able to deal with this. And he can always Pestilent Strike if he gets shot. Should be good. Also has Armor of Pestilence. They're trying to repair it, but I'm not going to be able to out-repair Plaguefish damage. Yeah, don't stop attacking it, dude. Couple more hits. There we go. Can he just face tank this Devastator now? Because of the Pestilent Strike, he can. Get some model. Look at this Plague Champion now. Almost level 3. Dreadnought took a lot of damage. A Predator tank will do that. This guy's got his right lance shoulder mounted as well. Bashing Power, I think, or something? Yeah, Bashing Power. Rocket Launcher Commando, though, in Tier 3 now. Can they get onto the rear armor of this tank? Sluggers sure are. Oh, maybe not. That Predator tank shot didn't seem to do a lot to the War Truck there. There we go. That was a rear armor hit. Wraithlord did not take a swing. Wraithlord taking a lot of damage from that rocket launcher too. Dreadnought now getting involved. Oh wow. It's a good volley from the Wraith Guard. Killed about 6 sluggers, it looked like. They're all reinforcing off the war truck, of course. Here comes a Dreadnought. Can they deal with it right here, right now? I think they can. Missile shots on the Predator tank. There's Blessing of the Omnissiah heal. They might kill each other here. That was a special from the Wraith Lord, which wasn't helpful, and we get a sync kill. That rips its Wraith Lord throat out and tosses it down. The Dreadnought lives. The Dreadnought lives. That was unlucky. The Wraith Lord did a special attack there, and they really didn't need to or want to. Fire Dragons on the way for the Pacifist. Looking very depleted now. Still in Tier 2 as well, as is Laura. Gotez just goes Tier 3. Might need Kuda to carry on that side. Stay stable with your Predator tank. Need to repair it for a start. No? Right there, guys. There we go. Warlock is level 3, now has Warp Throat. Will help deal with the double sluggers, which have been a menace. Level 2 and level 2. Where's the War Truck then? The War Truck is there. 307 to 273. Red Team taking the west side for a 2-to-1 cap. Bashing Power with Blastmaster? Sure, why not? This power generator is barely clinging to life. Level 3 Plague Champion. I think you could push against that with the Plague Champion and Mark of Khorne CSM. Very heretics. They're worshipping back here for no reason. Here we go. Stone Guard Veteran's in trouble now. I might have to retreat off that. Oh, Mark target for the Plague Champion. Level 3 Tech Marine. Just saw the high-powered shot there as well. Being chased by Assault Marines now. There's another jump. Heretics are there. Do they have Touch of Nurgle? They do. Touch of Nurgle is set to get a cost increase, which makes Grandfather Nurgle unhappy. Killed a Marine. I think this guy's done for, though. That was a pretty good shot. Killed another Assault Marine. But they're going to get onto the VP now. The CSM were not in that fight. They were Bashing Power or something. 290 to 273. Pretty close on victory points. And a battle wagon on the way for Leo built. Stone Guard for both of the Tech Marine players. First Company Marines that can change their ammo to combat all targets. At the moment, these guys have Kraken Bolts loaded in to shoot at these heavy infantry. Okay, turrets all over the gaff for Corrupted Jesus. One Las Cannon, one Heavy Bolter, and some Chaos Terminators. Could maybe get Lightning Claws and just rip through all of this stuff. Gotez with a Land Raider Edema on the way. And there's your battle wagon. Two units inside, you can tell by the light bars. If you do have a unit inside, it moves quicker and shoots all of its guns. Lots of more DACA. That's a good target for the big zap gun thing. Didn't see it there though. They're just going through the mid to bash power. Blue team did retake the west side. Tier 3 for Lauer. A late Falcon for the pacifist. Could be super useful over there though. Help everything reinforce on that. Oh, we have a Lightning Claw Force Commander Terminator. Or Terminator Force Commander, I guess. Ready to chop stuff up. It's a good stun bomb. It's a really good stun bomb. This could be a really messy fight here. Rocket Launcher Commander is looking for some vehicles. But gets knocked all over the place. Rocket Launcher now getting shots in. Oh, Plasma Cannon now getting shots in too. Need to move. Need to move from here. This Predator needs to move. I think they killed the Commander. Plasma Cannon killed the Commander. Looks like we have Autocannon Terminators taking some damage, but they teleport away. Vanguard Veterans there with power melee weapons are a big threat to those Terminators now. It's a good response to them. The Force Commander Terminator went down. Yeah, and there's the Commander. I wonder if the Plasma Cannon killed him. What is this? Some flaming going on. There's the Land Raider Redeemer. Vanguard Veterans somehow still have three models. Not quite. Plague Champion got one there. Can they finish him off? With the autocannon? I guess not. How do you have two models and 81 hit points? That's crazy. Level 4 Plague Champion. Now stalking down some Stern Guard. Look at the damage from that autocannon and those twin link bolters those guys have. That was pretty crazy. Caught them all bunched up for a second. Can they get one? They can. Falcon got it. West side now have a Land Raider Redeemer, War Truck, and a Battle Wagon. Some repairs from the Sluggers going in. And the Scouts. What is this thing doing? Turn around, dude. So Wraith Guard will help with that, with those big vehicles for sure. These guys are level 2 now as well. Terminator Force Commander still down. Can they get the revive? Yep, Warlock gets the revive, hits level 5 as well. Now have a Laz Cannon Predator. Better at taking on these vehicles. Getting some good shots. Really good shots on the battle wagon. Can a Wraith Guard get a volley now? They're getting inside. They're scared of the double Sluggers. We'll see maybe how the Lightning Claws do against those double Sluggers. Is it a better pick than the Thunderhammer? Still got Flamer Taxi. You might want to get a Plasma Gun or something, guys. 229 to 216. We have Corrupted Jesus has pushed through. Day Champion barely gets away. Did not get a decap, though. And we see Vengeance Rouse loaded in to shoot this super heavy infantry. There's some Nurgle Worship. And there's a Blastmaster. And there's Mark Target. Dropped a model there. These guys are really expensive to reinforce. What was that shot, Blastmaster? We're trying to hit the Scouts, I think, still. This could be a good shot here. Boom. Really good shot. Unlucky not to get two Stern Guard models off that. Refactor Field is up, giving him... He debuffs the accuracy of stuff that's shooting him. It's pretty good. West side. Terminator Force Commander trying to cap. Got a decap and runs. That's pretty good. Slugger's just trying to repair, I think. Fire Dragon's getting too close to shooty shooty. Falcon's actually done really well. What is this? Oh, Commando was trying to get on the rear armor of that Predator tank there. 202 to 216 on the VPs. It's still so close. Stern Guard. Wow, you haven't leveled up yet. You've been there for a while, guys. It's a good Plasma Cannon shot. What is this now? It's Assault Terminators from Jokuda. He's actually done really well to stabilize with this Predator tank over here. It's allowed the pacifist a little bit of room to breathe. They're going to get this Land Raider, I think. Those guys know how to use those heavy melee thunder hammers, and down it goes. Can this Predator tank survive though? It's being blocked. It's being repaired. It's being rear armor hit, and down it goes. Just as I said, how well that Predator tank has done. I think they're going to get this though. Is that an Eldritch? It is an Eldritch. Everything dodges it. But those guys did get the tank. Crashes into that thing. 1-to-1 cap, and now they're going to get the war truck. Talk about value from your assault terminators, eh? Falcon needs to put the shield up. There we go. Fire dragons, why are you moving so close, guys? Good Wraith Guard volley. Assault terminators kicking some ass here. Can they get the battle wagon as well? Very close to it. I love it. I love when they smack stuff with their shield. Oh no. Now being chased by sluggers. Marked target. And I think they used their teleport. They're going to go down here. They're going to go down. And they do go down. Sluggers do so much damage to those guys when they are leveled up. Vengeance round Stern Guard were down there as well, of course. Shooting them up. And a venerable Dreadnought comes in from Gotez. Topsy-turvy fights on the west side. Saw a bunch of vehicles go down. Then the assault terminators go down. The battle wagon barely survives. And now a venerable Dreadnought is here. So I haven't seen the Terminator Force Commander go up against the sluggers, really. Don't really want to fight the venerable Dreadnought. But I guess you're keeping it in place for the plasma cannon. Okay. Commando went for a little ride with his grappling hook. Why does it fling you that far? He put the hook there and it chucked him another screen away. This guy's now getting a VP cap going. What is this? It's a Land Raider Phobos from Corrupted Jesus. Got some more heretics up too. Can they get on the VP here? Can they get a triple? They might be able to get a triple. Guys need to cap though. There we go. Where's the Plague Champion? I thought he was here. Oh, I'm seeing things. He's back at base. There's your Dirge Caster. Yeah, need to melt those Stern Guard if you can. They're doing a lot of damage to these guys. A grenade goes in, actually kills a Terminator there. Okay, got rid of the Stern Guard. They can tank these shotguns pretty well. Good shot from the Blastmaster. Level 3 scouts. Surviving somehow. Here come the Vanguard veterans. Those guys did get the cap, and there is the triple for the blue team. My mouse is screwing up. There we go. Battle wagon somehow still rattling along and getting repairs. Here's a venerable Dreadnought with the Dark Age of Technology. Takes up to 2050 hit points at level 1, and that thing can level. So can these guys. First appearance of a Nob squad here from Leo built. Melee infantry that can go toe-to-toe with anything in the game. Don't have their... Oh, they do have their Nob leader. Fully upgraded now. They are a force to be reckoned with. More than a match for a Land Raider Phobos. Look how quickly they are tearing through it here. Pestilent Strike. Oh, didn't get the stun. Did not stun them. Used it a bit too far away. There's a Imperial Abyss from Corrupted Jesus. Didn't quite get the battle wagon. The Phobos does go down as expected. Did a decent amount of damage to the Nob Squad. Oh no. Gets dragged in by his own Abyss. Chaos fights itself. Uses the heal and gets away. Breath of Nurgle there. Those guys jumping on the turrets. I guess these turrets have done a decent job if they're still here. They're probably going to get them both. Am I hearing a rocks? Yes, I am. A rocks over here. I'm not sure if it hit anything. Seer Council getting on through, but no match for a venerable Dreadnought, guys. They're trying to get on those Marines. They will tear those Marines up. Fire Dragons. Shoot and run. Now eating some flame. Can the Wraith Guard get a hit here? Plasma Cannon gets a decent hit. These guys can now turn and fire again. Not sure if they'll get it though. He's got so much health. Is it already charged? This guy can charge. Oh. Terminator Force Commander says hello to these sluggers. He's already low health though. Why did you teleport in here and goes down? Well, there's your answer. Can he deal with level 3 sluggers? Not super well. At least not when he's on half health when he teleports in. Commando. Level 6 now. Getting a cat. Decent plasma cannon hit again. How is this battle wagon still held together? They forced them off. They're going to get the 2-to-1 cap here. Going to get a 2-to-1 cap. Gotez with a Predator tank on the way. Got the Venerable. We got a Knob squad up. There you are. Actually looking quite strong on this side now. Look at this though. Land Raider Redeemer for Joe Kuda. Needs to be so careful of the Knob squad. Needs to get that frag assault on them. And then Hope. Hey, Corrupted Jesus. You've got a lot of resources, buddy. Might be saving up for a great unclean one. Eldar helping out over here now. Stop the cap pretty quickly. And yeah, this might be a smart choice. Double up on this side. There's two VPs here, right? Go get them. Can you defend the power, Joe Kuda? That's a big zap gun shot. Almost wiped out the Devastators. Here it is then. You can retreat back to these things, so it gives you massive amount of infield presence. Kicking off towards the mid. Terminator Force Commander persuaded to leave by Vanguard, I think. There was a Venerable Dreadnought hanging around too. Fire Prism up now for the Pacifist, a Land Raider Phobos for Corrupted Jesus. The second one. Knob Squad are on the prowl. There's the Frenzy. They did drop a model, but this thing needs to keep moving. Frenzy gives them 75% damage reduction. Immunity to suppression as well. It's worn off though. Only lasts 8 seconds. You do need to pay 75 red to activate that thing. It's quite expensive actually. But well worth the cost. No doubt about that. I think it has a 1-minute cooldown as well. A decent hit. Gets rid of him. Look how much damage that thing took. Rocket launcher was also getting shots, I think. What is this? Oh, they're bashing power with a Predator tank and a Venerable Dreadnought. 133 to 42. Red team looking very strong now. Got a Melter Gun Tech Marine level 7. Venerable Dreadnought number 2, this time from Lauer. Already getting the Dark Age of Technology. Yeah, he could just go into base and wreck stuff there. Blastmaster gets a decent hit. Towards the west side again then. Assault Terminator is number 2. Trying to get a decap. Let's see what these sluggers can do with everything else. And there's Mark Target Zone. This is going to be bad for these guys. You got your decap and they teleport away. Are they even going to escape though? Sluggers are way faster. Especially if they get their melee charge. Yeah, there it is. I don't think they're going to escape. Desperately wanted a decap. But those guys pay for it. Frag Assault. Sluggers got level 4 and level 4. Yes, they did. They've been a constant threat in this game. Look at the map now. It's so red. 68 to 42. Venerable Dreadnought of Lauer has to charge away. And into some Eldar. Looks like the red team have this. Unless they can do some really effective ninja capping on that natural victory point. Down goes the Venerable there. 36 to 42. Blue team are going to get a natural back, and a Plague Champion is slowly making his way towards the enemy natural victory point. He doesn't have a lot of hit points though. He uses the Pestilent Strike. He thought those guys were going to go in on it. 18 to 42. They're actually in base here against Joe Kuda, who's all alone. Can they get onto that VP in time to make a difference? You never know. Vanguard Veterans got messed up. Almost wiped out on retreat, but they do get away. Why are you guys retreating? Are they trying to get back to base to help defend, maybe? I think you should have just come to this VP, guys. Gets the decap, 3 to 42, and more Chaos Terminators. Can they hold this? There's a Breath of Nurgle heal. Terminators take over the cap. Stone Guard getting wrecked. Do you have Mark Target? Yes, you do. Lauer asking for help over here. Did you guys wipe out the base? Nope. Took out one of the turrets. Oh, he didn't. There's still a turret here. What are you doing exactly? Level 4 Venerable Dreadnought in here is going to get wrecked. There's the 2-1. Red team are on their natural though. This could be it here. This could be it. Yeah, two knob squads showing up. Those guys don't have lightning claws. They're going to be torn up. And there's your game. Single cap at the end. Got it for the red team. Frantic ending. And some cool fights. We had a Terminator Force Commander. Never really been convinced by his lightning claws, to be honest. Compared to his other war gear choices. Had a level 9 Warlock. Providence at the end. Level 8 Plague Champion did well on this east side. Level 7 Tech Marine here. Melter Gun, Signum and Orbs. For Gotz. Gotez, or his name is. Rocket Launcher. And Sneaky Commando level 8. And a level 8 Tech Marine for Lauer. With a Refractor Field instead of the Orbs. And there you have it. It's a fun one. Thank you for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time.